Yes, good evening to all of you. How are you all? My voice is audible to all of you. Please let me know my voice is audible. How are you all? Everything is fine? Let me know everything. Yes, good evening to all of you. How are you all? I hope you all are fine and doing great in your life and everything is fine in your sight. Yes, good. So welcome to all of you in this another lecture series which we have today. Yeah, good evening to all of you, good evening. So I welcome all of you in this lecture series. Okay, good. So just waiting for 1 or 2 minutes more. So that other students will join along with us. So I hope you all have done your homework which I told you yesterday. So how are you all? So have you done your homework which we have discussed yesterday? I just get lots of, you know, your assignments on Telegram. I hope you all have done it. Yeah. So have all of you done the homework which we have discussed yesterday? ये संबंधित मैसेज कर यार यूट्यूब में आके कि इट्स गुड यू आर टेकिंग अनदर वन लेक्चर्स. वो बच्चों में आके मैसेज कर रहे हैं कि मैम यू आर टेकिंग माय लेक्चर या अदर्स लेक्चर्स. आप देखो ना ऑनलाइन होंगे, देखो उनके मैसेज देखो. सो यस वी विल हैव टू स्टार्ट अवर टुडेज लेक्चर विच वी हैव जस्ट डन दीज टॉपिक्स यस्टरडे. सो टुडे वी विल स्टार्ट फर्दर विच आर द सेपरेशन ऑफ मॉलिक्यूल्स बाय इलेक्ट्रोफोरेसिस. और वी विल स्टार्ट प्रोटीन क्वांटिफिकेशन, सेपरेशन एंड प्यूरिफिकेशन ऑल्सो. So yes, I have to tell you one more thing. I just want few more students to join so that I will let you know that your assignments are recorded by all of us. Getting my point. So you, whether you are not attending the lecture because of your exams or you have some another work to do, you can watch the session later on, no problem. But the homework which is given to all of you, you have to submit the assignment as soon as possible because we are keeping the record of your assignments. And I will suggest all of you to write your name on the assignment also, so that I will able to compile the list. Getting my point? So there are so many students in this MPPT batch who has not done the assignment till now. So I request all of you to please, if you are not attending the lecture because of any reason, you are allowed to watch it later anytime when you are able to, when you are able to do it, you are allowed to take the session at any time, but you have to submit the assignment as soon as possible. So if I gave you the assignment today, I gave you the homework today, so you have to submit it by 12 hours or by you can say by tomorrow if I gave you the homework today. So I request all of you to submit your assignments as soon as possible, because we are taking the record of your assignment, and along with the assignment you have to add your name also, your title also, and your name, and so that I will be able to keep the record of that thing. So please all of you, you have to do your homework as soon as possible, because there are so many students in the MPPT batch, they are not attending the classes regularly. No issues, they must have some problem, they must have their exams or something like that. It's okay, no issues at all, but you have to complete the homework, which I ask all of you to do. Okay, so please put this message in the Telegram also, that they all have to submit the assignment as soon as possible, otherwise they are just it will become very difficult for me at the end when you need the certificates. It becomes difficult for all of us, so please submit your assignment as soon as possible. Okay, so I think now we have to start the session. So today, like yesterday, we have done the recombinant DNA technology. Now we will have to start with the another lecture, which we will do on separation of molecules by electrophoresis. So we have to start. Hello, dekh lo message aap sir, मैं इस नंबर में ध्यान नहीं लग रहा सर, वो मुझे कह रहे रमनीत मैम ने लेक्चर ले लिया सर। सो यस, वी हैव टू स्टार्ट टुडे विद द अनदर टॉपिक विच वी हैव, विच इज ऑन द सेपरेशन ऑफ मॉलिक्यूल्स बाय इलेक्ट्रोफोरेसिस. सो वी हैव डन बेसिक प्रिंसिपल्स ऑफ एमबीबीटी, सेल कल्चर टेक्निक्स, रिकॉम्बिनेंट डीएनए टेक्नोलॉजी वी हैव डन यस्टरडे. सो नाउ वी विल मूव फॉरवर्ड विद द सेपरेशन ऑफ मॉलिक्यूल्स बाय इलेक्ट्रोफोरेसिस. आई होप ऑल ऑफ यू हैव डन इलेक्ट्रोफोरेसिस बिफोर ऑल्सो. So if any one of you have the knowledge regarding the electrophoresis, please let me know, any one of you, what is basically electrophoresis and for what purpose we are using electrophoresis. Just I want to know that, then I will start this topic. We want to, it is only the separation of molecules by electrophoresis, separation of the molecules by electrophoresis. So any one of you, have you know what is basically electrophoresis? Yes, Jagriti, please let me know what is electrophoresis. You are all are allowed to submit the homework as soon as possible, Muskan, no issues at all. But it's my suggestion only that please, if you are not able to attend the class, at least try to do the homework. It's my suggestion to all of you. So it's only my suggestion to all of you. Yes, very good. So yes, please, what is electrophoresis? So monochloroethylene, it is a laboratory technique which is used to separate the DNA, RNA, protein molecules based on their size and electric charge. Yes, very good, Monojit, very good. Okay. Separation on the basis of size bands will form. Yes, very good, Nancy. So I hope you all have some awareness regarding the electrophoresis, or you must have done any assignment, or maybe you have done practically also on assignment. So separation of the molecule according to their molecular weight and through the electric field. Okay. So molecular weight based on the separation. So separation of the molecules on the basis of size and charge. Okay, good, Meghna. Shah Ghazia, it's a separation on the basis of size by applying current. Yes, very good. By applying the electric field, by applying the current. Very good, Shah. Nilima, separation of the molecules on the basis of charge and size. Okay. And Yogita is saying, in agrocell electrophoresis, based on the size, different DNA fragments are separated and bands are obtained, which can be visualized by ethereum bromide. Very good, very good. Yeah. So some of you have done some practical work on electrophoresis. You are also aware regarding the paste. So it's okay. I just want to know whether you are knowing it or not, so that we will be able to discuss it as such. So Jaguriti is saying, separation of the molecules on the basis of charge and weight, a technique used to separate the DNA fragments based on the size. Nancy, separation of the proteins and nucleic acid. Yeah, very good, all of you. So okay, I will start this presentation on separation of the molecules by electrophoresis. It is a very small PPT of 20 to 24 slides only. Our main topic which we have to discuss today. So after completing the separation of molecules by electrophoresis, we have to cover these topics, which is protein quantification, protein separation and protein purification. So let me tell you, these three topics, they are related with each other. Protein quantification, protein separation, protein purification. We will discuss these topics in detail. We will discuss, but I will try to do it together. Getting my point? So either I have to take 1 hour, either I have to take 2 hours or 2.5 hours, but I want to take it together because all these things are related with each other. If not possible today, then I will take it tomorrow, but I want to take it together because these all things are interrelated with each other. So after separation of molecules by electrophoresis, we will start with the protein part. How to do protein quantification, how to do protein separation and protein purification. So please try to understand what I want to say, that we will do it in together. So that's all. So we have to start with the separation of the molecules by electrophoresis. Yes, very good all of you. So now I am just going to start with electrophoresis. After it, we have to start with the protein part, that what is basically proteins and what is quantification, everything related to protein. Okay, so I'm now just going to share the slides which are on electrophoresis. I will not put much time on this because I know all of you have done it before also. Okay, so what is basically electrophoresis? As you told me, that it is the process of migration of the particles, charged particles or molecules in a solution under the influence of electric field. So you have to keep this thing in mind, that electric field is must for the separation of the particles or molecules in a solution under the influence of a electric field. So they will separate it, they will migrate it, but electric field is must. So now, what's the principle of this electrophoresis? Many biological molecules such as amino acids, peptides, proteins, nucleotides and nucleic acids possesses ionizable groups, and therefore at any given pH exist in the solution as electrically charged species. So what is basically the biological molecules, like amino acids, peptides, proteins, DNA, RNA, all these biological molecules, we have amino acids, we have peptides, proteins, DNA, RNA, all these biological molecules, they exhibit a charge either cation or anion in a solution. So it is, this technique is basically for the separation of these biological molecules according to their size, according to their weight. So why they are able to separate it? Because they possess an ionizable group, and therefore at any given pH that exists in a solution, they can be separated. So under the influence of electrical field, these particles will migrate either to the cathode or to the anode depending on the nature of their charge. So they will either move towards the cathode or anode depending upon the nature of the net charge. So these biological molecules carry an electric charge, the magnitude of which depends on the particular molecule and also the pH and composition of suspending medium. So these charged molecules migrate in solution to the electrodes of opposite polarity when an electric field is applied, and this principle is used in electrophoresis for the separation of biological molecules of different charges. Getting my point? So these molecules, they get charged, either positive charge or negative charge, and then they will migrate in the solution to the electrodes of opposite polarity. Under the influence of an electric field, they will move either towards the positive, either towards negative. And by this technique, we are able to separate the biomolecules. We are able to separate the biological molecules. So electrophoresis is basically for the separation of the proteins and for the separation of the DNA. So we have to discuss all these things in detail also. So electrophoresis can be used to separate charged molecules such as DNA, RNA and proteins. So please keep this thing in mind that it is for the separation of DNA, RNA and proteins. So the electrophoresis, the separation will be on the basis of 2 points, according to the charge and according to the size. So according to the charge, if they are positively charged, they will move toward the negative end. Like they are positively charged, they will move toward the negative end. If they are negatively charged, they will move towards the positive end. According to the size, now how they will migrate according to the size? Obviously, when we are using the electrophoresis, when we are using the agarose, we have some pore size. So they will migrate according to the size. So the smaller ones, they will be able to move fast, and the bands will be there fast. And according to size, this is the separation. The larger one, they will move slowly, but the smaller ones, they will move fast. So this is the type of electrophoresis which we have, which is there. We have vapor electrophoresis, disc gel electrophoresis, agarose electrophoresis. Our main focus is on this agarose electrophoresis, isoelectric foxing. This we have to discuss in detail also. Then we have PAGE. This we will discuss in the protein part. And then we have SDS, which is sodium deoxysilyl sulfate polyacrylamide gel electrophoresis. So we have different types of electrophoresis. The paper electrophoresis is a very old one. So this technique is useful for the separation of molecules such as amino acids and small proteins. So a strip of filter paper is moistened with a buffer, and the ends of the strip are immersed into the buffer reservoirs containing the electrodes. So the samples are spotted in the center of the paper. High voltage is applied and the spots migrate according to their charges. So this is basically the paper electrophoresis, in which So this technique is useful for the separation of the small molecules such as amino acids and proteins. So paper electrophoresis is basically for the small molecules like amino acids. So strip of filter paper is moistened with a buffer. So if you are able to see here, I don't know what happened to this. So this is the filter paper which is moistened in the buffer. The samples are spotted in the center of the paper. High voltage is applied and the spots will migrate. So sample are present here, then according to the voltage they will migrate. And after electrophoresis, the components can be detected by a variety of staining techniques depending upon their chemical identity. So sample is placed, so the sample is placed right here, and with the help of these charge or with the help of this electric field, we are able to separate the sample. Now we have another term or another electrophoresis which is known as agarose electrophoresis, which is basically for the separation and analyzing the DNA. Now this is your homework also, that we have agarose gel electrophoresis, or we can say we are using agar, we are using PAGE, and one more is there, I will let you know. So you have to tell me the difference of all these. Let me complete it, then I will give you the homework. So in agarose gel electrophoresis, we are used it for the separation and the analyzing of the DNA. The purpose of the gel is to quantify the DNA or to isolate the particular band. So the DNA is visualized in the gel by addition of ethidium bromide, which binds strongly to the DNA by intercalating between the bases. So we have ethidium bromide which we are just adding in the gel. So when the ethidium bromide and the DNA, they will, you know, bind with each other, there will be the emission of the orange light. So when the DNA and the ethidium bromide, they will bind with each other, then there will be the emission of the orange light in the presence of UV light. So we have agarose, we have some buffers which are there. So this is the apparatus of the agarose gel electrophoresis. This is also known as horizontal electrophoresis. Now your first homework is, what is the difference between horizontal gel electrophoresis and vertical gel electrophoresis? We have two types of electrophoresis. One is horizontal electrophoresis and another is vertical electrophoresis. You have to tell me the difference between both these. Basically, the horizontal is for the separation of the DNA molecules. So you have to let me know about it. These are some steps which are there in the how we have to done the electrophoresis. I will let you know these all things in protein part also. So this is a sample. We have to put it in a pipette and then we have to load the samples in a gel. And after observation under the UV light, we will able to get the bands. And this electrophoresis is quite useful for the criminal investigations, the murders, or even for the paternity test also. Getting my point? So this is the applications. Now this is SDS page. This is another very important electrophoresis which is here. I don't want to discuss it here right now, because I want to discuss it in brief when we will do the protein purification part. But let me read this slide only. So SDS page is the most widely used method for analyzing the protein mixture. The method is based on separation of the proteins according to the size. So here in the SDS, the proteins, the very large protein molecules will be separated on the basis of size. It can be used to determine the relative molecular mass of proteins. So SDS is an anionic detergent. I will not tell anything regarding SDS right now, but SDS is an anionic detergent. So samples are first boiled in a sample buffer containing SDS and beta mercaptoethanol. It reduces any disulfide present that are holding together the protein tertiary structure, and SDS binds strongly to and denatures the protein. So if I am just going to show you, this is basically SDS. This is how the SDS which is there, it helps in the separation, or you know, to make the protein by heating with the SDS and mercaptoethanol. The SDS just make it negatively charged. The protein becomes negatively charged. So here it is an anionic detergent. So when we are just you know, samples are just boiled with SDH and beta mercaptan ethanol, what will happen? It reduces any disulfide bonds that are holding together the protein tertiary structure. So the structure will be denatured. So if you are able to see here, the structure is tertiary. That means the structure is quite complex. But by using SDH and mercaptoethanol, what we are doing is, we are just denaturing the protein. We are able to break the tertiary structure, and SDH binds strongly to and denatures the protein, because SDH is an anionic detergent. So each protein is fully denatured by this treatment and opens into a rod-shaped structure with a series of negatively charged SDH molecules. So the tertiary structure gets breakdown and we are able to get the protein with negatively charged everywhere. Negatively charged SDH molecules are present. So when loaded onto a gel matrix, the negatively charged protein, they will migrate towards the positively charged electrode and are separated by a molecular sieving effect. So the sample buffer contains tracking dye, usually bromophenol blue. After visualization by staining technique, the size of a protein can be estimated by comparison with a standard molecular weight marker. So we have to run it along with bromophenol blue, and then we have to check it by comparison with a standard molecular marker, or you can say by using the DNA ladder. So it is also possible to blot the separated proteins onto a positive charged membrane and to the probe with the protein specific antibodies in a procedure which is known as Western blotting. So we have to discuss Western blotting, Northern blotting and Southern blotting in detail. This is the all things which are there in the electrophoresis. So you have to keep only some important points here, that we have what is basically electrophoresis, how there is a separation on the basis of their charge and on the basis of the size, and the types of electrophoresis which we have. We will have to discuss agarose, isoelectric, PAGE and SDS in detail. The paper electrophoresis is very primitive one, and yes, in gel electrophoresis we are using agarose. So this is the apparatus of the gel electrophoresis. I hope you all get it. Now let me know. We will have to discuss all these things in detail also. Getting my point? So we will have to discuss everything regarding SDS in detail also. This is only just a presentation regarding electrophoresis only. The focus right here is only on the electrophoresis. Now you have some homework which you have to do. First of all, you have to let me know the difference between horizontal electrophoresis and vertical electrophoresis. So don't worry regarding SDS, please. We will have to discuss SDS in very detail. We will have to discuss everything in detail. Here is the agarose diagram. This one you want to discuss. Or this one. So this is basically the apparatus. This is a protein which you isolate, or you can say this is a DNA or the nucleic acid on which you want to work further. So you have to take some amount of the sample in your pipette. Then after it, this is the chamber. This is a gel chamber only. In this gel chamber, if you able to see here, this one is the gel. This is the agarose gel with comb. They have some, comb in between, in which you will be able to put your samples. So with the help of this micropipette, you will have to put the samples, and after it you have to close it this is the complete apparatus, na? So you have to close it. So this is, if you are able to see, this is the full gel electrophoresis chamber. The gel is present along with the samples. If you are able to see, these due one are the samples. These due one are the samples. So after it, we have to cover it. In this gel chamber, we have buffer also. So these are the electric field which we have to provide. We have cathode and we have anode end. So we have to provide the electric field, and these samples will migrate according to their charge and according to the size. So DNA is loaded in the wells in the egg growth, and they will be loaded. They will be migrated according to the size. Getting my point? So this is very basic technique. I hope you will get it. No issues at all. Is it clear to you now? So in the horizontal one, you have to tell me the difference between horizontal one and the vertical one. But yes, horizontal one is the very basic one, and lots of students are working on the horizontal one, and it is basically for the separation of the DNA molecules. But we have vertical one also, so this is your homework. You have to tell me the difference between horizontal electrophoresis and vertical electrophoresis. Right now I will not discuss anything regarding STS. We will discuss it later. The another answer which you have to tell me, not here but in the assignment, we have agar, we have agarose, and we have acrylamide gel. We have three types of gel. We have agar, we have agarose, and we have acrylamide, which is PAGE, a polyacrylamide. We have three types of gel, or you can say three types of gel because of all these compounds or chemicals. So you have to let me know difference between agarose, agar and acrylamide. Why do we need three different types of gel? This is a question. Let me repeat it. Like, we have agar, we have agarose, and we have acrylamide. The acrylamide which is there in the PAGE, polyacrylamide gel electrophoresis. So what is the difference between these three types of gel, and what is the need of all these? Why we, if agarose is there, what is the need of acrylamide? If acrylamide is good, then what is the need of agarose? So I hope you are getting my question. So you have to answer me in the, you can say, you have to answer me in the group, and also you have to mention me the name also, so that I will able to know that who has submitted the assignment. So it's my request to all of you that you have to mention your name also. Okay. So is it clear to all of you? Please reply. Please all of you, any reply. Are you able to get the question or not? No, you can, because my mail ID is only for your review papers. Otherwise, I am not able to read your review paper, so that is why I am not asking you to send your assignments on the mail ID. Otherwise, it will be difficult for me to work on your review paper. Review paper are more important, so that is why review paper should be there in my mail and assignment should be there in the group. Yeah, so what is the difference between horizontal and vertical electrophoresis? And the another is, why there is a need of different types of gel? So please write this question in the group also. Otherwise, they will ask again and again, what are the questions today? So any one of you, please, if possible, please write down the questions in the group also. Any one of you, please. Okay. So that is only the simple topic which we have to discuss. Now we have another topic which is on the proteins. So shall we start now? A little bit regarding the protein isolation quantification. Yes. Yes, if you have any exams, then no issues. You can send your abstract after 10th also. No worries regarding it. Please don't worry regarding it. If you have any another question regarding the review, please let me know. How is your review paper right now? Everything is going good or not? You are able to get something or not? And I'm really sorry if I'm not able to reply you personally in the Telegram. I'm really sorry because I have so many students. In my today's genetics class, I told them that I already shared the PPTs, and they said, ma'am, you didn't share any PPT. So I sometimes just get confused also. So please, I'm really sorry if I am not able to answer your reply, your messages. Please don't feel bad. If you have any query regarding the review paper, please let me know. Are you getting it? Everything is fine. Because today is 7th of December, and by 10th of December you have to submit me the title, the topic along with the abstract. Are you getting it? Everything is going well or not? Please let me know, because even yesterday also we are not able to discuss anything regarding the review. Are you getting it or you have any problem? Please let me know. Everything is fine. Are you able to do it by 10th of December? Please let me know. Please let me know, are you getting it? Have you any query regarding the review paper? So by 10th of December, I want the review paper, not the review paper, but I want the abstracts of all of you. Yes, if you have your exam, then you will have to take little bit more time, no issues at all. Try to do it, but if you are busy, then no worries at all. Yes, the abstract should be of 200 to 300 words only. 200 to 300 words are more than enough. That means 15 to 20 lines only. Because abstract is only the introduction, basically, that what you want to, what is there in your review paper, in your whole review paper. So it should be of 200 to 300 words only. Yes, Monojit, please don't say please. I know you have your exams. No worries at all, but try to do when you will be free. Actually, Vishwaji, the review paper is only for the internship. But if you are interested, if you are not in internship, but till you are interested in doing something extra, then you are most welcome. No issues at all. Yes, yeah, you can submit by 14th. All of you, if you have an exam, you can submit it by 14th. No worries. But yes, you will take more time for the review paper, but assignment should be on time, because we have to maintain the data, we have to keep the record of everything. So assignment should be on time, otherwise keep the time for review only. No issues at all. Because review paper is new to all of you, I know it is new to all of you, so you can take your own time, no worries. No, Himanshu, just give me, one or two days, I will definitely check the abstract. At least check me only once, then I will mail you that, kindly proceed. And then you proceed, just give me, one more day, I will definitely reply. I hope you mail me. I will definitely reply, don't worry. Let me check it only once, then you can continue. How many students are there along with you, Himanshu? Himanshu, you are alone or someone is there along with you? Please share your email ID also so that I will be able to check it. Please share your email ID also. Okay, so you are alone. Okay, just share your email ID so that I will be able to check your review paper as soon as possible. So now I think we have to start our Now I think we have to start our next topic, which is on proteins. We will just do a little bit regarding it. Because tomorrow I will complete it. We will just start the introduction of proteins and the steps which we have to do. Ma'am, review paper is for internship students or for everyone? Muskan Gupta, where are you? Right, 10 minutes before, because I already replied to Vishwajit Das just 5 minutes before. So you are asking the same question. So review paper for internship students only or for both? Now you are again asking the same question. So I just told you that it is definitely for the internship students. They have to write it. There is no alternative for it. But if you want to learn something, if you are not in internship but you want to learn something new, then you are most welcome. Okay, doing on cardiac optogenetic. So you have sent me your abstract. You have sent me your abstract, Himanshu. So I will check it, no worry. But I am not able to get your abstract right now. Okay, no issues, Muskan. Don't worry, please. Don't say sorry. No worries, please. So send me your abstract, Himanshu. That is why I am finding, that why I didn't reply to you. This is my email ID. Just send me your abstract and then you have to continue it. If you will not send me, then how you will proceed? Okay, so just go with it. Okay, so now students are waiting for the lecture. Okay, now we will start a little bit about the introduction, which is there related to protein, and we have to cover these things in the tomorrow also. So let me share the PPT. I'm just telling you the very basics, because the topic is protein quantification, protein separation and protein purification. So there is so much protein. So what we must know, what is basically protein? So protein are the biomolecules, we all know. So they are the proteins are the biomolecules which are composed of amino acids forming the building block of the system and performs most of the biological functions of the system. So proteins are the biomolecules composed of amino acids forming the building block of the system and performs most biological functions of the system, of the body. So they are the building block, and they are formed from the composed of the amino acids only. So proteins are the polymers composed of hundreds or even thousands of amino acids linked by peptide bonds. So we have hundred or thousands of amino acids linked by the peptide bond. So proteins are formed by the peptide bonds only. Proteins fall into three basic categories according to their shape and solubility. They may be fibrous protein, globular protein and membrane protein. So we have fibrous protein, globular protein and membranes protein according to their shape and solubility. So what are basically proteins? They are the biomolecules. They are composed of amino acid. Number three, they are the building block of the system. Then again, they are formed by thousands of amino acids which are joined together by the peptide bond. So in the proteins we have the peptide bonds. Now these are the proteins. We have fibrous protein, we have globular protein and we have the membrane protein, and each one has their own characteristic features like fibrous protein. They are the regular linear structures. They play structural role in the cell. Often they are water insoluble. So fibrous proteins are basically insoluble in nature. Globular proteins, they are spherical, they are water soluble. So you have to keep remember the difference between all these. So fibrous protein, the example is the collagen. Globular protein, the example is the myoglobin. And membrane protein, which is hydrophobic amino acid, the example is bacterial rhodopsin, a membrane protein. And it is also water insoluble. So we have different types of proteins. Now, yes, this is the organization of the protein. We have the primary structure, secondary structure, tertiary structure, and the quaternary structure. So primary structure is a very basic structure, which is very simple, in which the amino acids are joined together by the peptide bonds. The secondary structure will be alpha helix, beta sheet, or beta plated sheets, which are stabilized by the covalent, that means by peptide and disulfide bonds, along with H bonding, electrostatic forces, hydrophobic interactions, and van der Waal forces. After it, we have tertiary structure, which will be definitely a little bit more complex. So tertiary structure is definitely a little bit more complex than the secondary structure, and the secondary structure is a little bit more complex from the primary structure. The quaternary structure is consist of two or more polypeptides which links to each other by covalent and non-covalent interactions. So we have three types of structures. We have primary structure, in which we have the amino acids joined by the peptide bonds. We have secondary structure, in which we have alpha helix and beta helix, in which we have peptide bond, sulfide bond, and we have some hydrogen bonding also. The tertiary structure is little bit more complex, and the last is the quaternary structure. So this is the very first point, which is the how to do the protein purification, how to do the protein extraction basically. So there are some methods. Number one is salting out, dialysis, chromatography, gel electrophoresis. We will have to discuss all these MBBT techniques in detail. So this is again the proteins, which are the biomolecules composed of amino acids. The very first thing which is there, which we need, is the protein extraction. Similarly, like if you want to work on DNA, the very first thing is the extraction of the DNA. So this is protein extraction, the process by which proteins from the cells are recovered for the analysis purpose is called the protein extraction. So as some of you have already told me, ma'am, please share the extraction procedures. So basically, what is extraction? So proteins are extracted from the tissues for a wide range of reasons, including to compare the structure of proteins as expressed by different organisms. So why do we need extraction of protein? Why do we want to work on protein? What is the reason? The number one thing is to compare the structure of proteins as expressed by different organisms. To purify a protein in order to identify the gene. To resolve the protein by FGS page, we will discuss it. To assay an enzyme in a crude extract for physiological studies. To study the mechanism of action of enzyme. To study any type of parasitic diseases, or you can say to study the diseases also, we need the separation of the proteins. So number one, the very first step is the protein isolation, or you can say protein extraction. So isolation and extraction is the same thing. Okay, so how to do the extraction, how to do the isolation? So we have to collect the sample first, then we have to wash it, clean it, and then grind it into a fine powder. Cell lysis with the physical grinding and chemical cell lysis buffer methods. Separation of proteins from non-protein components, such as, like, along with protein, we must have nucleic acids and lipids also. But we want to separate only proteins. We don't want new DNA, RNA, or lipids along with it. We just want proteins. Okay, so for that only reason, protein isolation is necessary. So further separation of target protein containing fraction from the bulk proteins. Recovery of the target protein in a highly purified state along with the high yield. So this is the extraction of the protein from the tissues. These are the things which are needed. We need the if we want to extract the protein from the plant, we need plant, or you can say any part of the plant, we need liquid nitrogen, we need buffer, motor and pestle, and some centrifugation and centrifugation tubes. So now this is the procedure. So in the today's session we will only do the extraction of protein. So if you are able to see here, these are the leaves, these are the fresh leaves for the extraction of protein. So take isolate leaves in a petri plate and wash with distilled water to remove all particulate matter on the surface. Dry the leaves on the tissue paper without applying excess pressure. Apply after the leaves are totally dry, you have to weigh them. So weigh the required amount on a balance, that how much it is needed. Now what we have to do, now this is, if you are able to see, this is the ice tube, ice bucket. So ice is here, okay. Now what we have to do, we have to take a pestle mortar, and in the pestle mortar we will add the leaves. Now in the presence of liquid nitrogen, we will crush these leaves. With the help of pestle and mortar, we have to crush these leaves in the presence of ice and in the presence of liquid nitrogen. So along with the liquid nitrogen, we have to crush these leaves. So grinding the leaves and lysis buffer treatment. So grind the leaves, or you can say crush the leaves, till a fine powder is seen. You have to crush it as much as, so that you will get the fine powder. Now this powder leaves, we have to add the lysis buffer. This is a procedure of isolation only, you have to keep this in mind as such. So to transfer the lysate to the fresh append of tubes and add some more lysis buffer to ensure proper lysis of the cells. So vortex the tube thoroughly to mix the contents uniformly. After vortexing the contents, incubate the tube at minus 20 degrees Celsius for 1 hour. And at the end, what we have to do, take this tube and we have to centrifuge it. So the proteins at the end of this incubation get precipitated in the buffered solution. So when we are adding the lysis buffer, when we are doing the vortexing, when we are doing it for when we are treating it at minus 20 degrees Celsius for 1 hour, after it you have to take these tubes out. So these tubes, append of tubes, we have to take it out from the fridge and we have to centrifuge it. You know what is centrifugation? The machine in which we have to put our samples, and the machine will rotate very fast for 10 to 20 minutes. After centrifugation, what you will get? You will get the pellet in the down. So if this is a append of tube, so you will get the pellet here in the bottom, and the upper is the supernatant. So you have to discard the supernatant and you have to keep the pellet along with you. So after centrifugation, when we are rotating it for 10 minutes or for 20 minutes, you will get supernatant and pellet. Supernatant will be discarded, pellet will be stored. So this pellet is again washed and washed and washed, again centrifugation, again freezing, again centrifugation, and at the end you will get the sample. Okay, the sample will contain the protein. So you, at the end you will get the sample and you have to store it at minus 20 degrees Celsius for later use. Okay, so I hope you will get it. Similarly, like we have extracted the protein from the leaves, same thing is there if you want to extract it from the animal tissues also. So again, you will have to read this protocol again. Everything is same. At the end, you will get the protein by lysing buffer, by using centrifugation, by using refrigeration and everything. You will get the protein at the end. So you have to read this protocol by your own self. So yes, you can also able to extract it from fungi also. So you can extract the protein from any living cells basically. You can also able to extract the protein from the bacteria also. These are the things which are needed if you want to extract it from the bacteria. So you have to read these protocols by your own self, okay. This is only I have discussed about the isolation of the proteins today. Okay, so I think that's all for today, otherwise it will become too much for all of you. I will share the PPT related to this protein isolation, and I hope you all will get it. Tomorrow we will start with the another step which is there after the isolation. That means after isolation, what we have to do. So we will start with SDS, and we will start with protein quantification. Okay. Then we have to do protein purification also. So I hope this is fine for today. Yeah, that is okay for today. We will meet tomorrow, and we will discuss rest of the things tomorrow. Okay, I hope all of you will get it definitely. Till then, take care of yourself and good night from my side. And also I request all of you to please subscribe my channel so that you will able to know when I will get live. Okay, so you are not subscribing to my channel, I asked you so many times. So please subscribe to the channel also and keep supporting. Thank you all. Yes, we will meet at 9 PM definitely. No, I didn't discuss Western blotting yet. We will discuss it in a special lecture. Western blotting, Northern blotting, Southern blotting, we will discuss in a special lecture. No worries. So take care of yourself, all of you. Please take care. Good night. We will meet tomorrow at 9 PM Till then, please do the homework as soon as possible. Take care. Okay, Manojit, I will check it. No worries. Thank you all for being here along with me for this 1 hour long session. Thank you all for your patience. You are still here with me, and it means a lot to me. Thank you all. Yes, I will share some videos, some virtual labs, everything I will share so that you will able to know how to handle everything, how to handle append of tubes, which is basically micro pipet, how to add the sample. I will share, definitely I will share, no worries. So yeah, I have to complete today's PPT. It is up to 120 slides. Let me complete it, then I will share with you. Or I will try to share, just give me some time. Because today I just want to check your abstracts. So after your lecture, I have to sit for 1 hour more so that I will able to reply to all of you. So that is why I think I have to do that thing first. So take care of all of you. Soham, Anurima, Shafaq, Riya, Ipsita, Shafaq. Yeah. So I'm really sorry if I pronounce your name wrong. I'm really sorry for it. But yes, take care of yourself and good night from my side. Bye-bye. We will meet tomorrow. Yes, thank you all. So we will meet tomorrow. Till then, bye bye. Algae protein extraction notes. I will share the PPT with you, microbial news, and then you have to read it by your own self. Okay, I will share it. No worries. Thanks all of you for your patience. Otherwise it is very difficult for the students to remain along with the teacher for such a long time, and the teacher which you are not able to see. But I will keep my camera on from tomorrow onwards so that you will able to see me. And yes, we will definitely have more interactive sessions. Take care of yourself, all of you, please. Okay. Good night, Priya. Good night. Bye-bye. Hmm. ओके बाय बाय याशी, वेलकम टू यू, नो वरी. सो गुड नाइट टू ऑल ऑफ यू. बाय बाय.